Hi, in this video I will go through the topic optimization and how you can solve optimization problems using Python. Before I start with the topic, I will introduce some of my Python resources. I have made different textbooks and lots of videos and other Python resources. You find them at my webpage at this location. So here is an overview of the different textbooks I have made: Python Programming, Python for Science and Engineering, Python for Control Engineering, and Python for Software Development. All these textbooks and other resources can be found on my webpage. In this video, I will cover the following topics: optimization in general, where I will focus on finding the minimum or the maximum of a given function, and curve fitting, where you find an optimal model based on a given data set. For instance, finding the model parameters for a selected model that best fits the data set that you have. We will mainly use the SciPy library and the functions for optimization in this SciPy library. I will provide lots of Python examples in these topics. So let's start with the basics regarding optimization. So here I have a curve, and optimization is based on finding the minimum of any given function. So in this case, the minimum of this function is this point, and mathematically it is where the derivative of the function is equals to zero. So in this point, the derivative is zero, and it's the minimum point of this function. So optimization is important in mathematics, control, and simulation applications. So basically, it is all about finding the minimum or the maximum of a given function. For instance, in model predictive control, or shortened MPC, you can use optimization to find the optimal control signal based on some criteria and constraint. Here you see some of the challenges with the optimization. We have two types of function: convex function and a non-convex function. For a convex function, it's easy to find the minimum or the maximum, while for non-convex function, you could have a local minimum and global minimum, or local maximum and global maximum. And optimization for non-convex functions can be more complicated. And also, when you have more than one variable, in this example we have only one variable x, we could have x, y, z, etc. It also, the optimization challenge or problem becomes more complex. I mentioned that optimization are used in model predictive control, or MPC, which is an advanced form of control engineering, where we find an optimal control signal and where we use optimization theory. So the cost function often used in MPC is like this. So we have a function that describes some criteria regarding the system, and where this U is the control signal. So we want to find an optimal control signal that can be used by the controller, and in order to find the optimal control signal, we set this cost function, the derivative of the cost function with respect to U, equals to zero. And by solving this, we get the future optimal control signal. So if you see this in this figure, this blue line is, we could say this is the cost function, and then we find derivative of the cost function and set it equals to zero, and solve it with respect to U, then we have found the optimal control signal. In this tutorial video, we will only go through some general optimization problems, and we will not focus on MPC or other specific applications. So the optimization examples that we go through in this video will be general examples that can be applied on any types of application. So in this video, we will go through two main types of optimization problems. We will find the minimum of a given function. Here you see a basic example. We have this function. In this case, the function is y of x equals to 2x squared plus 20x minus 22. And we want to find the minimum of this function. And the other type of optimization problem we will go through in this video is curve fitting, where we have a model and a given set of data, and we want to find the optimal model based on these given data. So these are the two types of optimization we will go through in this video: finding minimum of a given function and curve fitting. So we start with a basic example where we are going to find a minimum of a given function. So this is the function we are going to use in this example: 2x squared plus 20x minus 22. And we want to find the minimum of this function using Python. But first, we can find the minimum by finding the derivative of the function dy dx equals to 4x plus 20, and then we set the derivative equals to 0 in order to find the minimum. And this, and when we solve this, this gives x minimum equals to minus 5. And as you see from this plot also, x minus 5 is the minimum point. And then we can set x 5 into this equation, and then we find the y value. And in this case, it will be minus 72. So the minimum point in for this given function is minus 5, x equals to minus 5, and y equals to minus 72, which is this point. So this is the minimum of the function, and let's use Python to see if we are able to find the same result. So let's start with a simple Python solution. This solution is could be used for simple problems or simple functions, but for more advanced and complicated functions and problems, we need to use more advanced functions for finding the optimization for solving the optimization problem. But in this case, we are using this function, and we will use Python to iterate through all values of y of x using a while loop. And inside the while loop, we compare y of I compared to the next value, y of I plus 1. And if y of I plus 1 is larger than the previous value, y of I, we have found the minimum. Of course, this yields only when we have one minimum on the curve. Of course, in general, a function can have multiple minimums and multiple maximums. And some of them could be local minimums, and other could be absolute minimum. So this is just a basic example to show the principle behind finding a minimum of a given function. So this is the Python code for that. We use the NumPy library, and we also want to plot it using the matplot library. So we import these libraries on top of our code. We define the function, and we create the minimum and maximum. In this case, we want to find the minimum in the area of x minus 20 to x 20. So then we just implement the function and calculate the corresponding y values for these given x values. And then I plot it, x versus y. And then inside this while loop, I just check if the values, the next value is larger than the previous value. And then if that is the case, we will just, the while loop will end, and then we will print a given x value and a given y value. So let's implement this basic Python application using our spider editor. So now I have opened the spider editor. The spider editor is part of the Anaconda distribution. Of course, you can use any kind of Python editor. But the good thing about Anaconda, when you install Python through the Anaconda distribution, you get the spider editor, you get the NumPy library, you get the matplot library, and you get lots of other libraries as included in this package. So by just installing Python through the Anaconda distribution, you get all you need in one installation package. So here is the Python code, as explained. Here is the function, I plot it, and inside the while loop I just check if the next value is larger than the previous one. And if that is the case, we have found the minimum of the function. So let's just run this Python code. As you see, we have plotted it. As explained, the minimum for this function should be -5 and -72. And also, in our Python example here, we have found the same solution. So x is -5 and y is -72. So based on this basic example, we have been able to find the minimum of this this function. Next, we will use and demonstrate some of the more advanced optimization functions, which is part of the SciPy library. So SciPy is a free and open source Python library used for scientific computing and engineering. And SciPy contains submodules for optimization, linear algebra, interpolation, image processing, ordinary differential equation solvers, etc. And the optimize module of the SciPy library provides lots of functions for minimization or maximization of a given function. I will start with demonstrating a function called fMeanBound, but you have lots of other functions: fMean, minimize scalar, minimize, etc. You find an overview of all these functions in the documentation for the SciPy package. So let's use the same example. We have this function as we have used in the previous example. And now we want to use the fMeanBound function, which is part of the SciPy library, and the optimize module. And hopefully we will, by using this function, we will find the same result as in the previous example, namely -5 and -72. So let's implement this example in our spider editor. So now I'm back in the spider editor. I have implemented this example. We start by importing the different libraries we need. We need NumPy, matplotlib for plotting, and the SciPy for using this optimize function. So we start by defining our function using and creating a Python function. So you just implement the function, the mathematical function, inside this Python function, and then we return the y value. You want to find the minimum for the in the area of x mean -20 and x max +20. And then we also plot the function, and then we use this fMeanBound function, which is part of the SciPy library optimize module. And the input or arguments to this function is the function that we have defined here, the mathematical function xMean, which we have defined here, and x max, which we have defined here. And the resulting value will be the minimum the x value, and then we can easily find the y minimum just using x mean as an input to the function. And then we can print x mean and y mean to the screen, and hopefully we will find the same results as in the previous example. So let's just run this example. We found the plot, which is the same as in the previous example. And also, we are plotting x mean and y mean to the console window. And as you see, we got the same result. So now we have used this fmeanbound function, which is part of the SciPy library, to find the minimum of this function. So far we have been able to find the minimum of a given function. This is a scalar function with one variable, x. We have used one of the functions in the SciPy library, and also we have used a basic while loop in order to find the minimum as well. But let's see if we are able to find the minimum of some more advanced mathematical functions where we have multiple variables. So in the next example, we have a function. It's called the Rosenbrock's banana function. It's given, the mathematical function is given like this, where we have two variables, x and y. And we will see if we are able to find the minimum of this function. Here you see a plot of this function. So this function is used to verify performance and robustness of optimization algorithms, since this is a demanding to find the minimum for this function. And as you see from this plot, the global minimum is inside this long, narrow parabolic shape, flat value. To find the value is quite easy, but to find the global minimum, however, is more difficult. So then, typically this banana function is used to see if the algorithms that we are using is good or not. So let's see if we can use these functions in the SciPy library to find the minimum of this function. So the Rosenbrock's banana function is given like this, and it is known that the global minimum is at this point a, a square. Typically we set a equals to 1 and b equals to 100. So let's do that. If you set a equals to 1 and b equals to 100 inside this function, we get the following function. And this is the function we are going to implement in our example, and we want to find the minimum of this function. And from this theory, we know that the minimum should, the global minimum should be at the point 1, where x equals to 1 and y equals to 1. So let's see if we can use some of the optimization functions in the SciPy library in order to find this solution. So here you see the Python code for this example. We start to define the Rosenbrock's banana function. I have defined this function inside this Python function. I just call the function banana. I define a equals to 1 and b equals to 100, and then we implement the mathematical function as stated here. And then I return the y value. And then we, in this case, I'm using the fmean function, which is part of the SciPy optimize module. And the input to this function is the name of the function. The specific area where we want to find the minimum from minus 1.2 to 1 in this case. And then we will, the return value or the result from this function will be the optimal value, and then you just print it to the screen. So here we are back in the Spider editor. I have implemented the necessary code. I import the SciPy library and the optimize module. And then I start by defining the banana function. It has two variables, x and y, but here I'm just using a trick. The input argument here is x, which is actually an array of two elements. x0 is x, and x1 is actually y. So this is a trick how you can implement this function, where the function has multiple variables, in this case x and y. And then we just return y, which is the resulting value for the function. And then we use the fmean, which is part of the SciPy library. The input is name of the Python function, which has been called banana. And then we can just print the resulting optimal value to the console window. So let's just run this on. And as you see, the resulting value is what we hoped for, x equals to 1 and y equals to 1. So we have found the correct solution using this optimization function called fmean in the SciPy library. So using this syntax could be a little bit confusing. Of course, instead of y here, we could use f like this. So then we have two variables in this array. X of 0 is x, and then x1 is actually y. But it still could be a little bit confusing. So then we could do it like this. Instead of x, we could just put var for variables, and then we can set x comma y equals to var. And then instead of using this syntax, we can just use x. So this is x and this is y, like this. So now we're using the correct variables x and y inside this function, and then it becomes more readable and understandable. So let's just run this example, and as you see, of course, we get the same result. So this is how you can use the fmean function of the SciPy in order to find the minimum of this quite challenging banana function. So in this example, finding the minimum of this banana function, we use this fmean function, but of course there are lots of other functions in the SciPy package as well. So let's see if you can use one of the other functions for the same mathematical function. So we have the same banana function. In this case, we will use this minimize function, which is part of the same SciPy library. So let's just run this example. So it's very the same as the previous one. Instead of fmean, we are using the minimize function, and the input to the function is the banana Python banana function here. So let's just run this example. From this function, we get lots of values, but in the bottom here, you see that we get the same results, x. The the minimum value of x is 1, and the corresponding y value is 1. So we found the same result using this minimize function as we used for this min function, which we found approximately the same results. And also, if you go back to the first mathematical function we used in our example, this function from this previous example, we used this fmean bound to find the minimum of this function, which was -5 and -72, using this fmean bound function, and we found the result using Python. But instead of the fmean bound function, we can also use other functions, which is part of the SciPy library. So let's try another function called minimize underscore scalar. The program is almost similar. So we define the mathematical function, we plot it, and then we find the result using this minimize underscore scalar function. So let's just run this example. We got the same plot, of course, and as you see, we got the same result, x equals to minus 5, and the corresponding value, minus 72. So we got the same results here as well, using different types of optimization functions in the SciPy library. So the SciPy library and the optimize module of the SciPy library contains many different optimization functions that you can use for different optimization problems. But you need to find and use the functions and methods that is best for your optimization problem. And this tutorial video only scratches the surface of the optimization topic. For more information about optimization using this SciPy, you can read the SciPy documentation. Here you find detailed information about the optimized module of this SciPy library. And you find detailed description of all the functions available. So far we have found or I have illustrated how you can find the minimum or maximum of a given function using Python, and especially using the optimize package or module of this SciPy library. And the next topic is curve fitting, which is another type of optimization problem. So in curve fitting, it's all about fitting data to a mathematical model. So we have some data points, and we want to fit those data into a given mathematical model. So curve fitting is also a sort of optimization problem. This means you find an optimal model based on this given data set. And you will find the model parameters for a selected model that best fit these data. So Python has lots of features and functions for curve fitting that allows you to find and create empiric data models. We will show some basic examples in this tutorial. I have other tutorials that give the topic curve fitting topic, where I explain and go through the curve fitting topic in more details. You find it, I have made other videos regarding curve fitting, and also how explain the topic in several of my textbooks. But in this video I will just give some basic examples regarding curve fitting. So let's start with this example. We have logged some data, which is these red dots here. And if you plot these red dots, we typically see that this could fit a sine curve. So we can use this model as a starting point. Y of x equals to a multiplied with sine x plus b. So this is the function or the mathematical model that we want to fit our data points to. So basically we want to find the unknown model parameters A and B using curve fitting, and we want to use Python and the SciPy library and this optimize module of this SciPy package. So here you see the example in this case. I'm using the same libraries, especially this SciPy library. I also plot it using this matplotlib, and I define the function as we have done in previous examples, where input is x and the model parameters a and b. So this is the mathematical function where we want to find the optimal model parameters A and B, and we plot both the given data points, and we find the mathematical model and plot the mathematical model in the same plot. So here we are back in the spider editor. I have implemented the code. So here is the mathematical model. So we are defining the model. We define the model inside a Python function. We call it the Python function. I just call it model, and the input is x and the parameters, model parameters a and b, and then here we have the mathematical function for the model. Then I will use one of the built-in curve fit functions, which is part of this SciPy optimize module. And input to this function is the model, which is defined here, the x values and the y values. And the returning value and the returning results from this function will be the optimal model parameters. So let's just run this example. And as you see, I'm plotting it. These red dots is the given data. And then we want to find the optimal model for this data. And we are going to use this model, y equals to a multiplied with sine of x plus b. And then we want to find the optimal model parameters a and b in this case. And then we will use these optimal parameters in order to plot the model. So the blue line is the optimal model found based on these given data, which is these red dots. And as you see here in the console window, these are the optimal model parameters. So this first value is a and this second value is b. So in this example, we use the curve fit function in the SciPy library in order to find an optimal model. Next, I will give a short overview of the least square method, or shortened LSM. The least square method requires that the model to be set up is to be set up in the following form based on the input output data. So y equals to phi multiplied with theta. And assume we have some data points, these blue points. So we want to find a model based on these points, an optimal model using the least square fit method. And the solution is is given by this formula. So this is the least square formula we can use in order to find the optimal model parameters. So assume the following basic examples. We have some data points given in this table from x0 to x5. So for 0 is y15, for x equals to 1, y is 10, etc. So we have these given data points and we want to find a linear model based on these data. This means we need to find the model parameters a and b, and we are going to use the least square method. So based on this least square theory, the data needs to be put on this form. This means this y will be equal to this array equals to the phi matrix will be this, and theta will be the unknown model parameters in this case a and b. And then when we have set the system on this form, we can find the least square values for the model parameters, in this case a and b, according to this least square formula. So here you see the Python code for this basic example. So we have this y array, the phi matrix, and we have the unknown a and b. I will show two different methods. We can use the built-in least square function in the NumPy library, or we can implement this formula from scratch, and hopefully we will get the same solution using both these methods. So we define the phi matrix using the array feature in the NumPy. So this is the phi matrix given here. This is the y array or vector given here and here. And then in the first example, we find the optimal model parameters just using the built-in function least square. And then in the next line here, we are implementing this least square formula from scratch. And then we just print the results in each case to the console window. And as you see below here, in both cases, we get the following values. It's an array of two elements. The first one, -2.91, and the second, 14.28, etc. This means A is equals to -2.91, and B equals to 14.29, etc. And this gives the following optimal model based on these given data. So we end up with the following model, y equals to -2.91x plus 14.29. So based on the least square method, we have found the optimal linear model, y equals to ax plus b, based on these given data. So let's just run this example in our spider editor. So now we are back in our spider editor. I have implemented the code as just shown you. This is the first where I'm using the built-in least square method. And here I'm implementing the least square method from scratch using this least square formula. And let's just run it. And as you see, I get the same results in each of these cases, namely an array of two elements with the optimal model parameters. The first one is A and the second one is B. So that's all. So in this video, we first started to find the minimum of some given functions. And then in the next part, we used curve fitting to find an optimal model based on some given data set. And in each of those categories, we've used the SciPy library and the built-in functions in that library in order to find the minimum. Here we use different built-in functions, and also here we have different built-in functions we can use, like the least square method, etc. So that's all. So if you want to learn more about optimization or other Python topics, take a closer look at some of my Python resources. You find them on my webpage at this location. So that's all. So good luck with your Python programming. Thank you.